What is up, Smacky Empire? Smacky Empire here, and welcome to Little Nightmares video on the channel. Today, as you can learn from the title itself, we are going to do a character tier list. These are basically the most important characters in Little Nightmares 1 and 2. Now, if you see here, we got tiers. We got S tier, awesome. We got A tier for real good. We got B tier for alright. We got C, which is below average. So this is technically the average. And then you go trash straight from below. And you already know who's going in there. Now you might have noticed that we don't have very Little Nightmares in here. It's because I didn't add them in. Technically, Little Nightmares 1 and 2. But you know what? I'm gonna put it on the screen. Pretender A. The Craftsman, or whatever his name is. You guys know who it is. I'm gonna put it at B. Butler B. That's all the important characters from very Little Nightmares. I know the Raincourt Girl, 6. Gnomes, there you freaking go. Let's move on to the next one. Alright, so we're gonna start off with Little Nightmares 1 and make our way from Little Nightmares 1 to Little Nightmares 2. We also have some characters from the DLC, if you can see already. So you know what, let's begin. We're gonna start off with 6, Legendary. I don't have to say anything. 6 is Legendary. I know, spoilers alert, what she did in Little Nightmares 2, but you have to understand, she is A-level, above A-level, the peak character in all of Little Nightmares. I don't think anyone else will touch her level of popularity, her level of everything that she did in Little Nightmares universe. Even if she's evil, she's bad, technically. Everything runs because of her and her deed. I'll talk more about it in my other timeline video, but if you want to catch up, you can watch story, explanation, and explanation video. Anyways, we move on to gnomes. Now, see, gnomes, technically, see, they are characters, but they're not really, like, enemies. They don't provide threat. They do help you. And we know their lore and story of how they turn out to be, or before they turn out to be gnomes. I like them, alright. I think their inclusion here in the game actually helps the narrative far more and actually fleshes out many other characters. Because of these gnomes, just because of this, it's a low A in my opinion. So any other character who's coming on the A, they're gonna come behind them just because of their lore and history in Little Nightmares universe. So I'm gonna move on to the next one. Okay, Janitor. See, Janitor is one of the only few monsters in Little Nightmares universe I actually like, or most specifically Little Nightmares 1 game I actually like. I actually grown to like him, and he's gonna go here. Janitor, I think because of his history and, you know, the resemblance of long arms with teacher's long neck, it actually goes hand in hand, and I really like Janitor. I think he's menacing, not being able to see what it's in front of him, just going from sounds, but what he's doing is messed up. We all know that, but actually, he gave me more chills, scariness, made tension even worse, like in a good way, and made it terrifying more than the chefs. So there you go, they're gonna go at A. Then we're gonna move to the shoe monster. See, shoe monster is a very disappointing one for me because I was super intrigued to know what is going on with the story behind the shoe monster. We just only see shoe monster here, and I believe we also see a little bit of shoe monster in the very Little Nightmares, correct me if I'm wrong. But shoe monster, actually, you know what, now that I think about it, he's going there. Shoe monster, you disappoint me. So much could have been done there. Other than this, living in the shoe? Like, who does that? Who lives in the shoe anyway? Shoe monster, that's why he deserves the F trash. So we're gonna move on to the next one. We have the leeches. Now, I hated them. They are the worst. I never liked them. I feel like they were just annoying. There are someone else who's more annoying than leeches, but one thing I will say, they gave me good scare. So you know what, just because of the scaredness, because every time they would come, things will turn dark and you have to use your flashlight and sprint. There's no other way to avoid them. So you do know what, because of the scaredness, they added something to the story. Good, yeah, maybe they're as close to gnomes. Then we get to the twin chefs. See, twin chefs, again, just like the shoe monster, were a little bit disappointing because they don't do much in terms of scariness other than being just big giant flesh going around left and right. So I'm gonna say they're all right. Then we get to the Lady Geisha. See, Lady Geisha right here. Okay, so I don't know about you guys. I haven't seen much reaction of what people think about her boss fight, but I feel like there should have been a longer sequence with her boss fight. Now, now that I think about it, it seems like I'm just complaining a lot with these characters. But know this, I love all of these characters except for the shoe monster and the leeches. Freak leeches, alright? I hate them for what they've done to me. But Lady Geisha, you would expect a much longer boss fight compared to Janitor. I feel like Janitor's sequence was far longer, 10 times bigger and longer than Lady Geisha's one. But Lady Geisha was mostly there for the story and lore, so you know what, because she plays an important role here, and she controls all these suckers for that trait, she's gonna stay here in the real good one. But at the end, just the lore, anything else that I reason, if it's better than her, she'll go down there. Yeah, Lady Geisha, you need to do better, because the build-up to Lady Geisha's boss fight was awesome. Then we get to the boss fight, it ends so quickly, and then we're here. So, you know what? Give me that, I'll keep it here. I'll change it later, but I'll keep it here. But before we end the first game, you noticed I left guests, because guests, ladies and gentlemen, you guys are not gonna believe this. Guests are far more scarier than anything other than Janitor, obviously, in the entire game. Maybe even more than Janitor. You see, the guests, they're pure thirst, hunger, obsession with eating us, and the way they just constantly eat, that is terrifying. The sequence of them, that was single-handedly one of the best sequences in all of Little Nightmares, all games combined. I know there are multiple shapes and multiple designs of guests, so I just chose him because, well, freaking why not? Whenever I think of guests, this is the face that comes into my head. Like, look at him. Freak that. Really good job on the guests. Let me move to the DLC. Now, the Runaway Kid. See, Runaway Kid is a real one. After learning what happened to the Runaway Kid, he's done bits. Unfortunately, he couldn't keep up Lady Geisha. We know what happened. Poor gnome became gnome. He's not on 6th level because, I mean, 6 literally beat Lady Geisha. I like him. I wanna support him, but you know what? He's here. Poor you, Runaway Kid. We will miss you. Now, see, Granny here, you know, Granny. Listen. There's just something about a Granny and that DLC that still gives me shivers. Look at this. Who wouldn't be terrified? Look at this. And knowing her role and being abandoned and whatnot, her, listen, guys, I don't have to say much on her. We're gonna move on to the next game, Little Nightmares 2. All right, we're starting off 6. I don't even have to say anything. That was Mono. I apologize. We're starting off with Mono. See, I still feel like 6 is more savage and badass than Mono. Mono is up there, maybe more than 6, but in terms of what just happened at the end, 6 always looks out for herself and she's a survivor. That's why she is still alive and way better than where Mono is. Like, listen, we're all sad after what happened, but you know what I'm trying to say here, right? Then we get to the freaking, which one should I pick one first? Okay, let's go with bullies. Freak bullies. Okay, here's the thing, they were far more annoying. I feel like there was a part that I got so frustrated. Nah, mate. So yeah, I really didn't like bullies at all. Then we get to the teacher. Teacher's all right. Listen, her long neck, it's terrifying. I am aware, all of that nasty doo-doo stuff, but she is alright, trust me. Then up next, I'm gonna do Hunter, and that is, he's trash. You guys know why. I made countless videos and why I don't like him. He's going there, and he's staying there. Actually, yes, he's staying at number one in terms, yeah. Yeah, you guys disagree, fight me. I'm angry. Then we get to the patients. Really annoying. I feel like another opportunity wasted, but here, I would say though, I really enjoyed the part after I was done beating them. At first, I wasn't realizing what was going on, and it was so hard to control the flashlight, but once I got the hang of it, yo, I killed it, and I felt satisfaction afterwards, which I didn't felt when I was done with bullies, so they're alright. Then we get to the freaking living hands. Listen, one was understandable, two was understandable. We had almost 4 living hands, and it was so annoying because they would jump all over the place. Oh, I'm gonna say below average. I feel like there should have been more patience with different varieties, but then again, I feel like they're planning same for bullies and the hospital. I feel like one or two are going to be in hospital and teacher's school, I feel like, because they missed so many areas. Listen, guys, Dr. Listen, Dr. Sequence was so fantastic, he could have been easily here, but after seeing what happened to him, he's low, alright, and almost up below average, so I feel like I do want to stay here with Doctor, because Patience gave me far more tough time than Doctor, but I feel like there is a theme, a recurring theme of bosses not as being strong as their, you know, allies like Patience, bullies, and you get the point here. So that is my final pick for these suckers. Now we move to the final territory, starting off with the viewers. What was the point of viewers there? Okay, so some of their puzzles got on my nerves a little bit. It doesn't take you long before you realize what you need to do, but they were so weirdly done. I feel like viewers part was rushed. I saw some of the viewers on the rooftops falling down the signal tower. I feel like we missed some things there. I feel like even though the whole story doesn't feel rushed, it seems like the viewers part or some of their parts has been cut, because there's so much. You barely interact with viewers. There's a chase scene, there are two viewers puzzles, and that's about it. Now I understand you have to fit all of that in the playtime of, you know, what we had, but I feel like viewers were really, I wasn't expecting much of them, so I'm not that disappointed, but I feel like, again, it is a little bit disappointing, you know what I'm saying? You guys already know. Listen, Mono, you have to move. Thin Man, easily the best antagonist in all of Little Nightmares universe, single-handedly his vague, abnormal approach compared to every single character in all of Little Nightmares universe makes him the best character /enemy/monster in the Little Nightmares universe. And now after learning his tragic story and history, he is up there for me. I made countless videos on him, why I love this sucker right here. Easily up there. Now you might be like, hey Smack, yo, hold on a second. Well, you put 6 over here. You guys are right. She doesn't deserve this, but I'm gonna put it here. This is where I feel like this is no one else is entering this. Alright, then we get to the signal tower monster. They like to call it flesh walls or something like that, signal tower. This character, since signal tower itself is a character in a way, it doesn't do much except chase you. Design is really cool, not what I was expecting in terms of understanding signal tower, but I feel like since signal tower, broadcasting transmission, and people consuming it, it makes sense for them to have eyes and flesh, because it consumes, brainwashes every single person, it takes away their skins. That's why viewers are like distorted and whatnot. So viewers are better than this, so it's way below average right there. I expected so much inside the signal tower, but then again, I feel like there might be another DLC inside signal tower, because there are so many locations. Why are you rushing towards all of them? Now again, I've said this before, the story doesn't feel rushed, but it seems like there are so many unexplored areas that you just left. You were like, sure, just move on. We only had one sequence of the signal tower flesh monster chasing us, and that's it. I would have loved to see more. I would have loved to see more of school, hospital, inside of signal tower most specifically. So I hope there's a DLC in the future, as I purposely avoided this. Monster 6. Listen guys, listen. Easily, Monster 6 is the best one after the 3. The way you follow the story and then you get this, understanding the lore of the first Little Nightmares and the DLCs and Very Little Nightmares, single-handedly for me, the scariest monster is Monster 6. Not just because of, you know, the design and looks and whatnot, but just the tragedy behind it, the emotions, the history, the community and whatnot. It just is heartbreaking. It really is. Monster 6, well done. Target Studios made the best decision when they were like, you know what, 6 is gonna be the monster for the final boss, and I loved it, ladies and gentlemen. Now I do feel like I am giving away these passes for free here, most specifically the Runaway Kid. So Runaway Kid, I'm sorry I have to do this. Yes, this is perfect. This is my last final one. So take a quick good look at it. This is my Little Nightmares tier character. This is the final one. I'll try to put the link in the description so you can add yours here. You have the awesome characters, the real good characters, the alright characters, the below average characters, and the trash, the garbage ones. I hope in the future, if we do get something like this, they do more for that on that, but I hope the DLC clears more of it. Once the DLC's out, I will go back and change this, rearrange this, add very Little Nightmares characters in here. But with that being said, do let me know what is your tier list. Once you made yours, screenshot it and tweet at me at @ThreadsMakingPie. I will check it out and react to it together. Now, with that being said, that was just my opinion. Don't need to take it seriously. Come on, guys. It's just video game characters. Don't hate me, please. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care and peace.